shit posting never ends, guys. I'm doing this blind. I'm scared. But here I go. I come to you now, relatively broken from what I would normally do. I know this video isn't going to make a lot of sense, so I decided to do it in a nonsensical way. There's not a whole lot that I can show you right now, but that's okay. You know exactly what I'm doing. Anyone who knows me well enough in real life knows that anytime they see me in front of a computer, I'm screwing around with Google Street View. I find Google Street View to be a fascinating tool. I use it as a sort of virtual tourism. It's fair to say I stand before you in these clothes. I sit before you in these clothes because it is 14 degrees outside right now, Fahrenheit. It was 2 degrees when I woke up, going down as far as 1 by the time I left the house. So now, I'm simply trying to stay alive. Yes, my house has heating, thanks for asking, but the problem is, it doesn't help. See, if I set the downstairs to the correct temperature, the upstairs becomes a furnace. And if I set the downstairs to a low temperature, upstairs becomes bearable. I can sleep there. But right now, I have to exist in this hell world that is the downstairs, because I have been a very busy man. I just got home from work. It is a random Monday evening, and I am unhappy. I'm unhappy because I'm busy. I'm unhappy because I'm challenged. I'm unhappy because I'm challenged by things I don't like or want. I made the mistake of taking all the fun classes first. This semester rolls around and I have no fun classes that I care about, no classes that I want to be at. Corporate finance, that's high-level accounting. Ew! Business law, too! Ugh, I can't even describe how uninteresting that is to me. And let me tell you the worst of all. E-commerce. E-commerce is going to kill me. My professor, tangential, it's very hard to follow. We've had many accounts of that. It reads like a string of nonsense, and it's always kind of been like that whenever someone with that degree of mental illness starts ranting. Her discourse in class reads exactly like that. She yelled at me during my introductory post. This is a class that should have been easy. This is a class that shouldn't have challenged me. But now I get 1 out of 25 on a discussion post for not following the topic when I perfectly followed the topic. I tell you what, it's going to be hell and I'm going to be glad when it's over. But in the meantime, I'm studying things I don't care about like corporate finance and business law and management science, whatever that means. And I tell you what, I worked 12 hours on my management science work over the weekend and I missed out on hanging out with my brother and my sister from out of town. So thank you, doctor, for presenting a challenge for me. I really care about your class and I want you to know that I appreciate it. Now the problem here lies in that I'm missing out on my life. What do I care about? I care about pursuing my interests. I care about pursuing things I like. Technology. I'm rebuilding my website, and it's going bad, and I need a lot of time. Time that I don't have right now. You see, I recently interviewed for a programming position, Software Developer 1, at my current company, and let's say it didn't go great. The man who interviewed me was a brilliant man. I really got the impression that he knew what he was talking about, but the problem was that I didn't know what I was talking about, and when he asked me about parallelism, I froze. He spent the rest of the interview, I'm going to use the word lecturing, but it wasn't quite a lecture in the negative connotation. It was explaining what it would take to become a proper programmer, and he covered a lot of bases of things that I should read and memorize and learn and see what it's all about. And I really feel like I'm on the right track for that. But the point is, I'm not out of technical support, and I may never make it out of technical support. And that would be the death of me, especially right now in this hardest of semesters. Work is going by well enough. Another of my coworkers got fired out of an injustice. The people who are failing the company continue on, and the people who are doing well are making it by. Barely. Where do I lie on that, you ask? I feel like my days are numbered. But I'm not going to stop fighting. I'm going to keep playing by the rules. I need this job more than I've needed anything in my life, and I respect it as much now as I did 8 years ago when I got it. I continue to study the things I don't care about, like corporate finance and business law and management science, whatever that means. And I don't have time to study the things I do care about. Web design, programming, learning actual object-oriented programming, maybe C#, maybe Java, something that'll actually be marketable if I do decide to become a programmer. I still have game ideas. I don't work in Unreal Engine anymore because it got too complicated for me and I realized I was in over my head. Learn C++ before you dive back into that. But I've still got the ideas in my head and I need to make them a reality, but I will not have time to do that anytime soon. So I continue to study things like corporate finance and business law, too, and management science, whatever that means, rather than the things I care about, like learning Japanese. If I really do plan to move there someday, I'd like to know the language so I don't have to teach English for the rest of my days. If you notice that my cadence seems a little weird this time, it's true. I'm taking a little bit of comfort in my surroundings. I'm taking a little comfort in my narration. I'm taking a little bit of comfort in my thoughts. There ain't no getting off of this train we on, and it's time to go. Week 3 of school has begun, and I'm on a crash course for failure if I don't get my ass moving. Speaking of moving, after the Japan trip in May, I come back here for 2 weeks to this house, and then no longer. I'm moving somewhere cheap. Hopefully, somewhere that I can save some money, pay off the student debt, and leave with a clean slate. I've got big dreams and big aspirations, and I can only hope you're here to join me. Thank you to all my friends, and thank you to all those who are there for me and truly support me. Thank you to my friends, and thank you to my family, and thank you to those who truly support me in my endeavors. I'll never be able to explain how much it means to me or how much I care. Thank you to my family, and thank you to my friends, and most of all, thank you to anyone who has... Thank you to my family, and thank you to my friends, and most of all, thank you to anyone who has been there for me along this massive journey that I've undertaken. We've got a long way to go, and we're not gonna make it there sitting on our asses and looking at VR. Let's start this shit up.